Tell us a little bit about your leg and how the rehab came along and where you are right now.
Right now, 100% ready to go. Wish I got it a little bit sooner, but right now feels good. Full on go in all the workouts these past couple of weeks, last month, and I'm just looking forward, very happy, very excited.
So you knew at some point that during the season last year there was something was going
to
have to be done.
Yeah, I kind of knew something was going to have to be done probably before that. So just try to play through it, try to listen to the doctors, see what they had to say, and went on from there.
Tim, you guys did a team bonding thing down in South Beach, down in Miami.
Mm-hmm.
Dwight was telling me that you got a place down there that was kind of like his idea, your idea, JJ's idea. Can you talk about that? Because everybody thought that was really pretty cool for the team to kind of go as a group.
Yeah, at first it was, we were supposed to go overseas at first with KP and go over there with them, you know, because we got a lot of European guys, as you all can see. That was supposed to happen probably in July, but it was so much going on with summer league and stuff like that. So we all decided to just let's do something, either San Diego, LA, you know, Miami, New York, something. So South Beach was the way to do it. You know, JJ has a place down there. I have a place down there. You know, it's sunny, nice, might as well. The week we were supposed to go, Hurricane Dorian couldn't do it. So they postponed it for the next week, and everybody got down there, and well, majority of the guys got down there that could make it, and it was a great enjoyable trip for us. It was great for team bonding, getting to know everybody as a team, and hopefully we can do it for many more years to come.
Was there much basketball talked about, or was it
no? It was basketball, no upcoming season stuff like that. We all, you know, got in the gym in the morning, weights, basketball, you know, played, and we got it in. So it was fun.
How difficult was it to go through the injury process? You had never been injured.
Never. It was hard. Had my father with me the whole entire. Both my parents, they were with me the whole entire time, and just a lot of talking to him, you know, again, to know what it's like being an injured player and what I have to do and what it takes, you know, to get back to 100%. And, you know, he had a bunch of injuries in his career. So just having him in my ear, it really, really helped me, especially throughout the treatment process and getting treatment and staying on top of that.
Your dad played for the Mavs. Did he talk to you a little bit about what's it like to play for the franchise?
I kind of remember a little bit. It's little things here and there, but not much. I just remember me living in Plano, coming to the games. Don Nelson, he allowed some of the guys to have their kids, you know, come on the road trip, and we went to Denver, watched them play the Nuggets that one time. So it was it's just little things I remember like that. Nothing too crazy. And but no, he doesn't really talk about it as much, you know.
How much benefit was it to be around the culture and with your dad, and maybe does, what does it carry over to now if it does at all?
As a player's son?
Right.
Oh yeah, it was some adversity, you know, expectations, you know, you have to live up to coming into this and growing up, and especially in middle school and high school and college. So. It was something that just I had to build tough, thick skin around, and with him being my father, you know, my mom is a little bit more harder on me than him, so I tend to listen to her more, cause I don't know why, but it's just something about your mom, your mother, you know, having that woman figure in your life, it pushes you a little bit more. So, but yeah, it just helped me throughout the whole entire process, just knowing how, what to do and what not to do on and off the floor, how to prepare yourself as a true pro, and all the little other things that come with, like financial and all that stuff. So being smart with your money and being smart with everything else around you. So.
You played with KP, obviously, in New York.
Mm-hmm.
Can you tell us what can we expect from him this season?
A lot of people don't know, man. It's hard to have a 7'2", 7'3" guy that can move like this. And people don't understand. You know, it is. I mean, people laugh and joke about the unicorn thing, but it is true. Like, that there's not, like, it's like you're playing with a creative player. You could throw the ball to him anywhere on the floor, and he's going to either score or have a presence, you know, on the floor while you're out there. A rim protector, guy that can dribble the ball, push the ball up and down the floor, communicates out there on the floor, a vocal leader, shoot the ball from anywhere on the floor. Everybody knows that. And he put on some muscle. He put on a lot of muscle this offseason and while he was out. So all I remember him saying is that he's ready. He's been ready. He just had to hold out and make sure once everybody's all in one, you know, we all start getting rolling, get the ball rolling. So it was I'm happy that he's back.
Him and Luka obviously are the star duo. What do you see your role next to them? How do you fit in with those two?
I don't know. I think I just more so have seen, I've just been watching a lot of, I always compare these two, these guys, Steve and Dirk. You know, Luka and KP are like probably the next generation of that. Luka being obviously a little bit more taller than Steve. But when those guys were playing against one another, Steve and Dirk, you know, Finley was on the team, and he was a little bit older than those guys. So I feel like me, you know, that would probably be my role, you know. I've been watching a lot of film on how he played around those guys and how he was effective and how he impacted the game. So just moving forward, I'm going to continue just wataching film on him and getting ideas from the coaching staff and from KP and Luka on what I can do to, you know, be an effective guy on this team.
Yeah, Finley was like a 20-point scorer. His stats declined as those two rose.
Mm-hmm.
Do you see the same thing as a possibility, or, you know, you adapt?
No, it's all about adaptation, you know, at this point. Adapting to your role and I know I'm not going to be that guy in New York where I was last season, shooting the ball 15 to 20 times a game, you know. I'm going to have to be more effective, more efficient, and I know that moving forward. So whatever I have to do on the floor, you know, take the load off those guys, you know, I'm going to be willing to do it.
Rick has talked about the lineup flexibility, players making sacrifices. Does it matter to you if you're starting or coming off the bench?
Look, it matters. Like, if an NBA player says it doesn't matter, like, that's it matters, you know. But at the same time, you have to pick and choose your battles, you know. It's whatever the coach has the last say, and you just have to roll with it and you have to stick with it. And me as a ball player, you know, I came off the bench, I started in this league, and for me, I was effective in both scenarios. So at the end of the day, whatever Coach Carlisle wants to do, he's going to do it, and we're going to have to roll with it, and we're going to have to trust him. You know, this is a team. It's not about yourself at the end of the day. It's about the team. And I'm all for it. I'm behind it 110%, and I'm willing to do whatever I have to do, you know, to get the job done.
We're talking about the importance of team culture. How do you think this team's culture is, like, how well do you guys match as a unit?
Yeah, I mean, it's just a lot of new guys. You know, we're starting to, you're starting to see a identity being built around, you know, these two guys and KP and Luka, and for the team, you know it starts with those two guys. We have to do whatever we can to help them out and correspond to them. They got to do the same for us. So at the end of the day, I think, you know, moving forward, we still have to try to treat this thing as we don't know each other, and we're trying to get to know each other, even though we've been around each other for months, you know, just so it can, psychologically speaking, it could improve it even more, you know, get us over that hump even more when we're facing adversity or when we have ups and downs, you know. People know when to choose to, when and where and how to push each other's buttons. And I think that's what training camp is all about. going into this week. So I'll probably have a better answer for you after training camp is done.
Speaking of chemistry, could you talk about the kind of personality that Boban brings?
This guy, Boban, I mean, he's funny. He's a funny cat, but, you know, he's serious, man. He's serious about his work. He's serious about his job. And this guy, you know, he has a nice touch around the rim, can shoot threes. You know, he's a big presence out there on the floor. But, yeah, Boban, man, he's funny. He's going to keep that locker room jumping. I'm excited. I'm happy just to have him on my team. My dad coached him when he was in Detroit, so he told me that you're going to have a guy that's going to uplift that locker room, whether you guys are having ups and downs. You know, he's going to put a smile on your face. So I'm very looking forward to it.
The West is always tough. There was a lot of moves made in the offseason.
Yeah.
Do you guys feel like with the team you have assembled that you guys are a playoff team?
Yeah, I feel like that. We are definitely a playoff team, and I'm not going to think otherwise. You know, you can't put doubt in your team at all. We have, as long as we are together all year, and then when adversity hits, we can overcome that very, very quickly and get past it and win the games that you're supposed to win. Yes, I feel like we can make the playoffs and we'll be a playoff team moving forward.
What's the story behind you banking in three-pointers? I saw watching the video the other night about you.
It was, well, that just comes with me knowing. In middle school, me and my dad used to play horse in the backyard all the time, and he'll get me with bank shots from the three-point line, college three, all the time. And I was just tired of losing, so I just kept practicing it. And I mean, I'd do it in a game here and there, but we have to be up by a lot, I guess. It's just all from middle school, man. Middle school and high school, playing horse with my dad and his buddies and hating to lose. You know, that's where it comes from.
How old were you when you really started to beat him consistently?
I would say like sophomore, junior year of high school. Yeah.
With your dad, does he ever look at the paychecks these days and say, man, around 20 years too early?
Yeah, he does, but he said, he's the first person to say, don't even look at that. You know, it's a different generation now. Yeah, I mean, it's tough. It's a hard thing to look at, but, you know, at the same time, it's
a family business.
It's a family business, yes. Scratch my back and scratch your back, Dad. It's all good. It's all good.
Okay, just a couple more questions.
As if y'all have any more. Y'all good? You said what now?
What are you looking forward to most this season?
Just staying healthy, man, and just finishing the season. You know, it was a hard thing to go through not playing the last 10 or so odd games. You know, it's just not me. I like to go out and battle with my guys, whether I'm hurt or not. It was just at this point, I was playing on it for a whole year. After I sat out those 20 games, my first year back in New York, and just constantly favoring it, and it just got to a point where I was tired of it, and I had to take it. I had to be selfish at that point, you know, for my career, you know, and on top of that, to be able to help those guys out moving forward, and not hiding it, you know. So that's just my expectations for myself this year. But for as a team, we got to make the playoffs. That's the thing. Make the playoffs, make a huge jump this season. And like I said, we're going to face adversity and up and down, so we'll be able to overcome it.
What specifically did the injury impact when you were on the court?
A lot of times I couldn't even jump off my left leg to dunk. You know, in Atlanta in my first year in New York, you could see that. But after that, it was just a decline in that, pushing off left, playing defense. I only jumped off of 2 feet a lot of the times after that injury. It was just hard. You know, it's in your shin, your muscles around it, and your calf. You know, it's hard to build when it's an injury like that. So everything is favoring that leg and favoring that areas, and it's just hard to have control over that. You can't control it.
Do you
You feel good now?
Huh?
You feel good now?
I feel great. Excellent. Good? Thank you all. Appreciate it, man.